Hello and welcome back to Pemberley Farm. Today, as you can see, we are doing some seeding. We're in the class and it's March the 28th and we've got started on the seeding. We only have two fields to do, but we might as well do this ourselves. We're no point in getting the hired work to do this one, so it's one of those jobs that he's doing. We're seeding wheat in this field, and it shouldn't take us too long because we do have a pretty good drill. We've got a drill that is will allow us to expand fairly easily when we come to do that. Let's turn that and down. Good. And this class is easily up to this job. Not much has been going on in the last few days. Cows and pigs and sheep all seem happy, and sheep will soon have some lambs, which will be fantastic. Ah, there we go. On to the marker again. On to the marker. There we are. Reverse up a little bit. It's gone a bit far. And it all seems to be working pretty well. I hope they continue to do so. For the main part, though, we're just getting on with stuff, getting on with the work on the farm that needs doing. And this is the major bit that needs doing at the moment. We need to get our crops in, make sure that they're in with plenty of time for us to be able to harvest them later in the year. Out good. Ridge markers, the classic old way to mark where your next bit. None of the GPS or anything like that. GPS doesn't seem to be working at the moment, so I don't quite know why that is. But instead, we're going to use. We'll just use the ridge markers in the meantime until we can figure out what's going on. There we go. Let's switch markers. Go again. Yeah. Yes, I like this drill. This drill works well. It was a bit of a risk when I bought it for the farm. It has a lot more attachments and a lot more options than some other drills do, but it seems to be working okay. Yeah, it seems to be working very well, in fact. So. Hopefully it will continue to do so. Round. Go. We are eating up this field. I'm happy to say it's going. We're motoring through this. This class is a nice tractor. It's, like all the tractors, it came with the farm when we bought it. But I think this must have been a fairly recent purchase for them. compared to the masses on the farm and the Fendt, it's a very, very much more up-to-date tractor. And as a result, it's actually what does most of the heavy lifting on the farm for us. And the Fendt has some power, but not quite to the level this does. And by that I mean that the horsepower on this is still only about just over 200 horsepower, I think, whereas all our other tractors are sub 200, and the little Massey is sub 100. So it's yeah. And this Cedar takes quite a bit more oomph than most of the tractors on the farm can provide. There we go. But fortunately not more than the Axion here has. Does the job handsomely. So yeah, there are still plenty of things. I mean, the cows will need another feed again soon. They're doing all right, but yeah, the cows, it appears, are always hungry. But then, considering the cows both here and on Kendal give us our base for running the farm, I have no issues with that. They are our bread and butter. But here we are looking to rely on a little more than the cows. We do only have two fields at the moment, but we're looking to buy at least a couple more, and a couple of larger ones as well. That way we can expand the farm and make a bit more of it. We're gonna do some slightly different stuff on here than we've done on Kendal. Pemberlin is all about how we expand the farm and expand the business. So, I mean, the expansion starts with us buying the farm in the first place, but while we're here, we have the ability and have the option to earn more, and that's what we're looking to do, is looking to increase what we can do fairly quickly too. I have my eye on a couple of the fields in the area. There's one the other side of the sheep paddock, which would be very useful to us. So far, the owner hasn't asked me to do any work at all, or hasn't had any extra work that they said they might like. So. But we'll keep working on it and keep trying to drive the price of the field down a bit. Yeah. Yeah, we're a good man through the field now. I'm happy with that. This is the right Cedar for this farm, I think. And it does work really nicely. There we go. Where's my Mickey marker? Do I have one out? I don't at the moment. There we are. Go. That is working wonderfully. This should be a very nice field of wheat at the end of the day. Which will provide the farm with both an income from the grains and and straw for the animals, which is great. I might put, I don't know whether to put wheat in the other field, or to be honest, we do need other crops as well. So we do need, well, with the pigs, we need everything. We have a thing where they take, yeah, they take a lot of food, and yeah, to get it mixed properly, we need a bit of everything. So that's also another reason why we need more fields. So I think we might put some sunflowers in. We need sunflowers, soybeans, or there we are. Sunflowers, soybeans, or canola, or OSR, and we need some corn as well. Corn, we don't have a corn head of the combine in there. Actually, I need to double check that. I need to check what we have for our combine, actually. To be honest, we might have a corn header, I think. If I remember correctly. Right. Yeah. This time around, we're going to do the headlands at the other end and get that done. There we go. To the tractor in our groove. And then we can go and get the heading done here. Don't need the ridge markers for this anymore. Sure that I am actually getting all of the headland, of course. And I miss bits. There we go. Headlands are always a pain. Get them right, they can be really easy things to handle. There we go. I'm very satisfied with that. Oh, it's been a been good, that has. I'm pleased with how that's worked. Away we go again and get this headland done. last strip down the field. And we get the headland up here done as well. There we go. This headland might be a little more challenging. It appears we've missed. We've gone quite deep in places. Never mind. I don't know. Actually, we have more width than I realise most of the time. Right, let's give it a go. Up the hill. Yeah, I like the power that we have with this tractor. It does work very nicely, very, very nicely. Alright, and then last bit of headland to go, I think. Yeah, we'll get that with the width of our seeder easily. There we have it, pretty much all done. Just need, so now the next thing here is going to be to get some fertilizer on it, I think. Get some solid fertilizer, because this is not a fertilizing cedar. There we are. Right. So I'm going to end the video here. I hope you've enjoyed this visit to Pemberland Farm. Please give it a like, drop us a comment and give it a share. And for all the latest videos from the farm, along with much, much more, please subscribe to the channel. I will see you next time. Goodbye.